Hey y'all, what's up? So I wanted to get in on this worst of Psy stuff that's going around, and so I was looking through all my Psy stuff, and I really can't pick a single song or album as being their worst. I mean, on everything that comes out, even the stuff that I thought I didn't like so much, you know, there's a few songs on everything, at the very least, that I really like a lot, so I can't call anything of theirs the worst, or even pick a single song. I mean, I'd have to listen to absolutely everything over again just to try to pick a song that I really, really, really don't like. But, I thought of something that someone else mentioned in a video, and I guess I would pick that as the worst for Psy, because it's kind of like my what the fuck moment for them. And that's Dayton Family's Cocaine. And you know, I've seen Dayton Family at the gathering and at shows, and you know, I've thought they were pretty cool on stage and everything, but when Cocaine came out, I was just bewildered by, you know, everyone going along with it like it's really fresh and stuff. It's like, really? You know, I know we're not all on coke, you know. And, you know, as you know, myself, I don't use drugs. Yes, I used to be a pothead, but I kind of fell out of that a couple years ago, and, you know, I don't do drugs, so I just don't think a lot of us can relate to it. I know that there are those drug-a-los out there, but, yeah, most of us, I just don't think it really fits us, and I don't think we really want to be seen as, you know, the hardcore druggies that people think we are and whatnot. But anyway, I wanted to go ahead and agree with Testoni's video about Vanilla Ice being on Psy. Now, he may be a cool person, he may be homies with them, and he may call himself a juggalo, and that's all good and fine. I'm cool with him. Got no problems with him. All much love and respect for being a juggalo and being their homies and, you know, all that. But I don't think he fits on Psychopathic. I mean, I really haven't heard his latest stuff, but I still don't think he has that whole horrorcore kind of theme. And I know what they do is they only hire their homies and relatives, basically. If you're not related to them, if you haven't hung out with them since high school or something, you know, you're not gonna get into Psy as a fucking janitor, you know what I'm saying? So I know that's what they're doing. I know that's why they're putting them on. But yeah, I really hope they do not stick him in Dark Lotus. Like, no, 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 no. And it's nothing against him. I don't know enough of his songs to know about him lyrically. Seriously, all I know is Ice Ice Baby, and that is definitely not Dark Lotus. But, I mean, as for Riders, I would say don't put him in Riders either, just because they've got enough people in it now, and the new albums that they just came out with were fresh. I like it a lot, but, I don't know. I mean, Riders is all fun and games and everything, so if he jumps in on a couple of Riders tracks, I mean, it's whatever. It's just for fun, but no, do not put him in Dark Lotus. No, 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 no. That will make me slip my fucking wrists, please. Okay, but yeah, that's about all I got. Yeah, there's really no worst Psy album for me or a song that I can think of at the moment. I like all their shit, and when I talk about Psy, I'm just talking, you know, ICP, Twisted, Blaze, Boondocks, ABK, Lotus, and Riders. You know, that's my shit, and yeah. So, that said, peace out. Ooh.